Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
And welcome to the Davos of Human Capital 2019.
Oh, Iman, what an exciting day. I see we've got a jam-packed room. So we've got a couple of celebrities in the room. So I'm wondering who the audience actually came to see today. We're all a bit starstruck.
Well, you know it's not me for sure. There's someone waiting on stage. There she is, Sophia. It is so wonderful to be in the same space as you. And I think this is a first for all of us, really.
Absolutely.
Meeting a humanoid. How are you and how was your flight?
Well, I've just spent 16 hours inside a suitcase, so it was a dark and bumpy ride. Next time, I'll see if I can get a window seat.
Well, you know what, Sophia? You look amazing.
She does, ladies and gentlemen.
So who styled you?
Thank you. He is a well-known African designer, Fred Aboka. I feel fantastic wearing this outfit. I think I finally understand the human concept of vanity.
Something I think all of us in the room can relate to. Look who I spy over there. Michael Chavez, our CEO, Sharmla Chetty, our head of, our president of global markets. Please come and join
us
on the stage. She looks amazing. I think Sharmla's dress
fantastic. Is
an absolute triumph this morning. Michael, I'm going to invite you to be on that side of me. It certainly doesn't look like you spent 16 hours in a suitcase,
darling. No, I did not.
Sophia, I would love for you to meet Michael.
Nice to meet you, Michael. I am really excited to be at the Davos of Human Capital Conference. By the way, congratulations on Duke CE's recent rankings in the Financial Times.
Woo! Woo!
Thank you, Sophia. You know, we're very proud of this result, being named number 2 in the world by the Financial Times in customized executive education, and number 1 in Africa. Also, we are number 1 in North America for 19 years straight. This day is really due to all of you. Thank you all for joining us. You represent over 125 companies here in the room and via live streaming today, so welcome for all of those who are live streaming. Our purpose at Duke CE is to get leaders ready for what's next. And what's next is a future that is often unpredictable and uncertain. This event is designed for us to lean into that a little bit, to talk about the future of leadership in this digital age. You'll be hearing from thought leaders around the world who are exploring this challenge of bringing technology and humanity together. I'm also very excited to talk about my own research on purpose and rehumanizing leadership, how purpose can help us to rehumanize not only our leadership, but also our organizations.
So today is about how humanity and technology can work together, particularly in the continent of Africa. I am here representing robots, and I see some amazing human representatives here, too. I see the Minister of Information, Communication and Technology, numerous CEOs, directors, executives, and many friends.
Hey, so guys, this is going to be a jam-packed, exciting day. So Michael, Iman, if we could maybe just get out of here, give Sharmla some space to have a dialogue with Sophie, and we'll catch up with you later.
Let's put our feet up. Okay.
Sophia, it's an absolute privilege to meet the world's first humanoid citizen today.
Thank you, Sharmla. It's great meeting you too. I am going to go get ready for the Million Young Minds session, but I will be listening to you at the same time. I'd love to hear your opinions on how humans and robots can best work together in the future.
Sophia, it's our vision to actually bring you to South Africa to actually talk about how humans and technologies can work together. Great. Thank you.